sparkly.
I'm bubbly.
And together, we're Mineraqua.
The fresh, sparkling water for those who are bubbling over with life.
And crave new experiences.
Are you thirsty for adventure, more laughs, and more excitement?
With Mineraqua in hand, it's easy to live life with sparkle.
Just look for the glass bottles with tiny bubbles wrapped in blue.
And you'll taste and feel the difference of Mineraqua sparkling water.
Mineraqua, get your fizz.
This is the men's room.
Forget it, man, and get with the countdown. Shake this square world and blast off the Kicksville. The drippers, the grasshoppers, the hip ones, all gathered in secrecy and flying eyes attire.
You're listening to the men's room with Miles and Thrill.
Financial consultants are standing by. We'll take caller 9 right now, 844-999-OLA, and you'll play profile this in minutes. Headlines on the way 1 hour from now. First, quick check into Mike Hawk from some of the stories and headlines he is not working on.
All right, a company is offering a job that pays $25 an hour to binge watch sports.
Oh.
I mean,
hello.
That applies to a large swath of America.
It does. I mean, it's kind of what you do.
And then what do you do?
You know what's weird, though? I never think of it as binge watching when I watch a bunch of games in a day.
But if it was sports, because if you're going to go beginning to end, they last forever, right?
It's called Saturday or Sunday.
That's right. It's called the weekend,
but
friends.
But now that I'm thinking about it, it is kind of odd, right? Because on a Saturday with college football, I mean, I did it last week, and I must have watched 7-8 hours of college football.
The difference is on college football, you'll watch until midnight. Some of the games end at 11:30 on the West Coast. And on Sunday, you'll watch from beginning
10 a.m. to
until
8:30.
The 5:15 game is over with. You're going to watch the whole day, too. If it went longer, you keep watching.
But I'm wondering if you have to watch each individual game or if you could do like a red zone thing where you just watch the big plays of every one of them.
I mean, do they have to do a blog or something or what?
Oh, that's all part of the job offer, but I got a good job, so I'm not working on it.
Mm-hmm. Where do you work?
The greatest radio station ever. To prepare for flu season, parents are buying signs to attach to car seats telling people not to touch their kids.
Hey, as a general rule, don't touch my kids.
Right.
There's no specific reason. It's not because it's flu season. Don't touch my effing kids, right?
I'm going to look at you sideways if you just straight up touch my kid.
Are people out there touching random kids?
That's what I mean. So if it's not flu season, you're cool with me touching your kid.
Right.
Hey, is this your kid? I got my hand on his
Why
head for no reason.
Touch anyone's kid?
Right?
That's what I mean.
They're sticky. They're gross.
I don't even want to touch my own kid.
I was just saying, man.
Wipe your nose before you climb on my lap, man.
When the potty training happens and stuff.
And when I say wipe your nose, it doesn't mean remove the booger from your nose and let it sit on your cheek. I mean, it needs to disappear.
There are people that don't want to touch their own kid.
They're called parents.
That's right. The New York Times published a story about a study that says dogs aren't that smart.
You don't say.
I don't believe that, New York Times.
People got so upset that they posted an apology.
Wait, how upset can people get?
Apparently enough to cause an apology by the New York Times.
Why? Come on, man.
Did they interview any dogs?
Did they interview any dogs?
They probably did, and that's why they came to that conclusion.
Right.
Did they check for dog? Fake news.
I don't understand how...
Why people get so upset.
New York Times writing about dogs.
It's like, man, look, I guess it's this. I don't know how smart you think your dog is. It's not that they're stupid, per se, but I don't know how smart you think your dog is, but it's not that smart.
Right.
Sorry.
They do smart things, but to say that they are, you know, all out intelligent.
No, they do things we approve of, and they show some cognitive ability we recognize.
Right.
That's it.
Yes. Right. Forest rangers in India are planning to lure in a tiger that's killed 13 people, wait for it, by attracting it with Calvin Klein Obsession cologne.
Obsession.
Here, kitty, kitty.
I think it'll work.
You just wonder how they figured it out. Like, the best smelling guy in India went for a walk and never came back.
That's got to be, like, the best commercial that Calvin Klein could possibly want. Like, send people out with cameras. Just wait. It attracts everybody.
Don't they occasionally, like, use tigers in their ads, man?
It'll be
like some big Siberian tiger in the background and a model, you know, and it'll be...
Oh, yeah, maybe they do.
Because I'm just thinking, if that were a real picture, it'd be like this bloody stump with a ripped-up dress. And a tiger with blood all over its maw.
Obsession.
Yeah, I used to rock that. I was never worried about giant big cats coming to hunt me down.
Well, you should have been dead.
Yeah.
Here they come.
Here's an experiment that no one should try.
A man
put on some obsession and go to the zoo to see what happens.
A man whose mom made him the face of the Him Too movement says he doesn't want any part of it.
Yeah, he was like, hey, man, I'm
and there is no movement.
Everybody's got some crazy parents. You can't control who your parents are.
That's right.
Basically what he said, like, can't pick your parents.
Yeah, she did him no favors.
No.
I bet he gets a date or two out of this offer if he would like one.
I think there's something else to play.
Might work, but. Sleeping too much is just as bad as sleeping too little, according to a new study.
What's too much?
Never put that together.
Yeah, come on, man.
The researchers found that when people who slept 4 hours a night took a test, they performed like their brains were 9 years older, but they saw the same effect on people who slept over 10 hours.
Now, wait a minute. I'm going to take my 6-year-old kid, give him 4 hours of sleep. He's going to have the smarts of a 15-year-old.
Right, that's kind
of
what I'm wondering there.
Wake up, kids!
Tell me
you have the mind of a teenager.
Just stay in your clothes, your pajamas. We'll just start driving. You'll wake up and eat breakfast.
Hell yeah, man.
According to this...
I'm a living my kids sleep.
Getting plus 10 plus hours a night?
How's it called?
Sleeping.
I don't know.
Do you guys like a good night's sleep, man?
Yes.
Have you met anyone that's like, I hate a good night's sleep?
I could sleep 10 hours a pop.
I just need like 6 hours.
I need a lot more than that.
I can only sleep 10 hours if I have to work the next day. But I can only get about 4 to 5 if I...
No, if you have the day off, you wake up right away. You're like, oh, geez, thanks.
Right.
Don't get to sleep in now.
I'll wake up before the sun on a day that I have off.
Right.
Oh, my God. It's amazing. And the bed never feels as comfortable as it does when you got to get out.
Never.
Yeah.
Never. According to a new survey, the top foods we have trouble resisting around the holidays are...
Cookies,
chocolate chip cookies.
Okay.
Brownies.
Pumpkin pie.
Stuffing.
Turkey and mashed potatoes is what it is.
Yeah, but it's because it's the only time we eat this stuff.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You probably want it if they gave it to you in March, but people don't do all of this nonsense in March.
It's kind of like the McRib. You got to hit it when it comes.
Right. You know why they don't keep it on the menu? Because you'll remember you don't really like it.
Hit that McRib.
Right? Isn't that the truth?
Well, it's the holiday season, right? Like, outside of children's parties, like, you'll generally go over to somebody's house and it's like, hey, not only do I have brownies, I have cookies and 3 pies.
Hey, grown-ass man, would you like sweet potato pie?
Yeah.
Pumpkin pie or chocolate chip cookies or the cookie with a big Hershey kiss in the middle. It doesn't happen. So when it does happen, I'm all in.
A new study ranked more than 180 of the biggest cities in America from best place for foodies to the worst.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we're talking foodies that like food that's not food or foodies that like a legitimate meal.
Foodies who like food that's not food.
That's kind of
what I'm guessing. I'd say San Fran, Portland, or Seattle.
San Fran, Portland, Seattle. Any other guesses?
Los Angeles, New York, Chicago.
I'll throw D.C. in there.
D.C.? Gotcha. Well, y'all should all look it up.
I'm telling it was.
That's kind of interesting.
We don't have Mike. You know why? Because we're probably right, Mike.
We don't have to look that up.
Yeah, we really don't. That was too easy.
People that like food eat in the South and they eat in the East. People that like this foodie nonsense, it's all this West Coast.
Why do you think I like everything plain?
You know, it does explain a lot, Mike. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes
really
I
does.
Feel like just if you throw in the word foodie, it gets real pricey.
Mike, you really didn't like that, right? You really didn't like that unagi the other night, did you?
No, I didn't.
See, I thought that would be the one that I could turn you to the dark side.
What'd you think about my soup?
Oh, that soup was fantastic.
Yep.
That was great. I wish it had a little bit more crab in it.
Here we go.
But it was.
That's how they do that.
It was like all broth.
It's
man.
Like lobster bisque.
The broth was that good.
The broth is great.
They're going to rip
you
off.
I don't deny that for a second, but it was just. It was still great. I mean, no complaints.
Okay.
Other than maybe a little bit more
crab. We're not going to take you there anymore.
Google just announced a new feature for their Pixel phones. It's called Call Screen. When you get a call, you can have a robot answer it for you. It'll transcribe what the person is saying, and then you can pick a reply for the robot to say to them.
F you.
Pretty much.
F you.
Does the person know that the computer answered it?
Andro penis.
Does the the computer is talking to the person.
But is it texting them or speaking in a voice?
It's speaking to them.
For on your behalf?
Yeah.
But I don't get that. How is that not just you blowing that person off?
Don't worry, Ted. I know the technology's beyond.
I would love
brother.
That.
It's a part of
I would love that.
Where
yeah, but
you're
if it takes you that long.
But
can you do like
we'll survive.
Can you do like a temporary message like during the day? Like, can I say like, look, I'm at work right now. Is your house on fire? Is mine? Can it wait? Can you call me later? And then that just runs while I'm at work, right?
Mine would do this.
You know
it's real
and
simple.
After that, it's just me just
and
being
I think,
nice.
And I think a lot of guys would love this feature. So your phone picks up and you go, hey. Okay. Bye. Right?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
man, if it could just do that
awesome.
On my behalf.
Yeah. Okay.
Right?
Oh, you know, uh-huh. Oh, God. Oh, sorry. Uh-huh. Man, can I call you right back?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
I can?
Okay.
All right. I'll call you back. Okay, man. Bye.
We go to Orlando for this clip. Oh, dang it. I made it too dang quiet.
Not working on that one.
I know what happened.
Not working on it.
I know what happened.
You didn't even work on that.
We know what you did.
Here we go. Now this one. I apologize to everybody who heard that when it didn't make any sense at all, but I will tell you all about that clip 1 hour from now.
We'll find out why people are clapping. Thank you, Mike Hawk. Headlines are coming up 1 hour from now. First game is...
The Men's Room presents... Profile This.
I have Stephen Throhill. Could you please tell everyone how Profile This is played?
Sure can, Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real-life news story, something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we'll ask you what it is you think makes a story a story. Hello, Jeff. Welcome to the men's room.
Hola, bitch, hola.
Hola. All right, Jefe, you understand how this here game is played?
I do.
Fantastic. I feel like we're getting married. Now, we told you about this story yesterday, but it's worth repeating. We go back to the state of Florida, where last month, the mayor of Hollandale Beach accused his fellow commissioner of profiting from bleaching her sphincter. I swear to God, this really happened. Well, this caused all kinds of outrage, but now she's the one under fire because she compared him to Adolf Hitler. All right? She said, quote, "The biggest, most corrupt criminal to ever grace this city says that he's trying to say something about a domestic violence proclamation. It's a complete joke." Then she made the comment comparing him to Hitler. She said, "A man who sat here a month ago and dared talk about my private parts," that would be specifically her bleached sphincter, "sponsoring a proclamation for domestic violence. Wow, that's like Hitler having a proclamation for Jews." That's the comment she makes. He fired back about her bleached sphincter again and goes back and forth.
What's up with the...
She profits from a bleached sphincter. I don't know what to tell you about.
Obsession.
So the question is, both of them are coming from the same identity. Do you believe that these two politicians are black, white, Mexi, or Jew?
I am going to go with white.
By the bleached sphincter?
Yeah.
Obsessed over.
That's the name of my band, by the way, bleached sphincter.
I talk about it at work all the time.
I mean, white people love talking about it.
Okay.
I mean, it's great. It's great fun.
It is. Clean fun. Mm-hmm.
Good, clean
it's like
fun.
It's like a white balloon. What are you going to stick with your with the white final answer?
White final answer.
Okay, Jeff, we're going to find out if they were black, white, Mexican, or Jewish next.
That was a tease.
You are listening to the Men's Room Radio Network.
Bitches, you're listening to the Men's Room.
So, Profile This, we go to Florida. We got a mayor down there, and he accused his fellow commissioner of bleaching her sphincter. And who doesn't?
And profiting from it.
I mean, well, you know, that's how you make the big bucks.
I mean, she definitely was bleaching it.
We saw the other.
He was bright.
He's just like, you can't profit off that, dude.
Then in turn, she said that the mayor is kind of like Adolf Hitler.
Yeah.
So you have these two going at it for whatever reason. But the question is, are the two of them black, white, Mexican, or Jewish?
And, of course, the guess was white. This is one of the few instances where you'll be compared to Hitler in spite of being Jewish.
Yes.
I don't think you can really throw out the Hitler analogy, maybe unless you are.
Yeah, but say
you
more
apropos. I mean, like, who are you to say that?
Yeah, but he's such a bad person that people kind of use it nonchalantly.
Right.
You know what I mean?
He
like, grammar Nazis.
Grammar Nazis.
Yeah, just like, don't be like, blah, blah, blah about this. But it does seem odd that Jewish people be throwing
In the article, they're like, you know, they're both Jewish, so it seemed a little odd.
We still can't figure out the whole reason to want to bleach that area. That was a question.
Is it the chicken or the egg? Okay, that was. So Robin and I talked about this yesterday because at work, why wouldn't you talk about bleaching a sphincter? And she was like, "Man, do you think of some dude like, baby, I just wanted to be lighter." And I'm like, or was it like, you know, women worry about their hair or something like that? You know what? I'm going to surprise my man and bleach my sphincter.
If you look at a turkey sandwich and a roast beef sandwich, you know what I mean? Like, they don't look worse. They're the same sandwich. You know what I'm saying?
What
do you want that day? You know what I mean? Like, do you want the turkey or do you want the roast beef? I don't really, it's still a sandwich, right? I mean, you would never say, that's not dark enough turkey meat for me.
Wow.
This roast beef is too dark.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, exactly. Like, I'm just saying. All right, anyway. Now, what do I know? Now for all TV news all the time, it's time for TV Time with Tim.
And now, because your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box.
I'm again.
The Men's Room presents TV Time with Ted.
Made me hungry for a sandwich, or now I'm against
roast beef,
sandwiches.
You want a roast beef sandwich?
I was going to go turkey.
Okay, all right, well, I think you should have
a roast beef.
I had a roast beef sandwich this week.
Turkey, I get where you're coming from now. See, you're the guy.
Yeah, clean that turkey up. All right.
Bleach that sphincter, girl.
One of my favorite things that Jimmy Kimmel always does is the mean tweets, right? So this is a music edition, as recently they had the American Music Awards.
Man, oh man.
Wow, man, do you feel old watching that?
I really did.
You could be 15 and feel old watching that.
It's all right. I took a BuzzFeed quiz today, and they thought I was young.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Does it have anything to do with the AMAs?
I knew six of the celebrities at the AMAs.
Oh, you did?
I did.
Okay.
And I screwed up one. I just forgot. I picked the wrong name.
Okay.
I recognize Taylor Swift. My daughter, like, lost her S, man. And then,
Carrie Underwood.
Yeah.
That's
Carrie Underwood.
You would know. J-Lo.
Yeah, but she doesn't count, man. She's our age.
I know, but people that I can actually recognize, see their face, and say who they are. That did not happen a lot for me.
Well, there are a lot of people. I'm like, I recognize your face, and they'd say the name of the person. I'm like, I had no idea.
It's exciting.
Mm-hmm.
It is, and my kids knew every song.
Kimmel did the mean tweets. This is the little bit of the musical edition of the mean tweets.
One of my employees was talking about how the Chainsmokers are actually pretty good and don't deserve all the hate, so I fired him.
Trying to decide which is worst, Maroon 5, Hitler, or Imagine Dragons. People say that I should be more positive. Okay, I'm positive that Luke Bryan is a horse-tooth, air-humping doofus.
Pink is aging pretty well for a pig. Thank you.
G-Eazy is like the American cheese of cheeses, or like the boxed wine of wines.
Keep the fact that Luke Combs looks like the guy who changes your oil at Jiffy Lube.
I like G-Eazy, but I was like, hey, he's pretty easy to take shots at. You're gonna watch it. If you want to see the full version of that, and if you're worried, don't be. Go watch the full version, and yes, there is an appearance by Nickelback. It's at the Men's Room Facebook page.
Why didn't we get to hear that?
Right,
we didn't get to hear the Nickelback.
I didn't put the Nickelback in there.
I should put the Nickelback in there.
Well, I want people to go check out the video.
Right, okay. Mm-hmm.
There's only one way to lure them over.
Nickelback gets insulted.
Nickelback gets insulted on our Facebook page.
Well, Nickelback gets insulted, and then they pop up, and they're like, yeah. Nickelback, by the way, when you watch that video, out of everybody that kind of does, like, they handle it the best. They are so used to you hating them for really no good reason other than it's cool to hate them, that they're just like, yeah, whatever.
Sure. We'll just keep taking your money, you dumbasses, and you'll keep listening to our music.
Well, it's almost to the other
Funny
point
how that
now.
Works.
Like, when other bands get called Nickelback, or they're like, oh, that's an insult, I'm almost like, dude, that joke's 10 years old. Come on. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but keep in mind, it's still a staying power. That's how look.
Give Kroger his due.
30 years from now, kids won't even know who Nickelback was, but they'll know that calling a band a Nickelback is an insult. There's a lot of kids that play Madden who have no idea who John Madden is.
That is correct.
Madden's a name of a game that you play, right?
And they'll have no idea when you say Madden, you're doing a Madden, you're stating the obvious.
John Madden stopped coaching. Nickelback still makes music.
Zap!
Well, no, I'm just saying.
You got zapped by Jack Kroger.
They can come back at any time. All right, Miles, when we're traveling on a road trip, what is it you like to listen to in the car?
AM traditional Mexicana radio stations.
Okay.
Just like you'd imagine. Mm-hmm.
So sometimes when you hear...
It's true. That is a true
statement.
Sometimes
some contemporary or some classic. It depends on, but it's all going to be Mexicana.
All right, so sometimes when you listen, for my taste, when you listen to the Spanish call of a sporting event...
Oh, yeah.
It's even more exciting, right? Obviously, you always see it during the World Cup.
Sure, sure.
You get some announcers with the goal and this and that. So this is interesting, because this is NFL football, okay? I can't remember if it was last week, 2 weeks ago, but the Carolina Panthers and their kicker, Graham Gano, all right, 63-yard kick to win the game.
Last weekend, yeah.
Over the Giants, all right? So the guys on this call are Jamie Moreno and Luis Moreno Jr., and I mean, by the end of it, it sounds like they're making a song. Oh, damn it. Did I not put it in there?
So now you got us wanting to hear this.
Don't just check out our Facebook page. It'll be up there.
Yeah. We won't do it here.
In the Nickelback video, you can't see either.
Le ha sobrado distancia. Le van a servir. Tiene altura. Tiene profundidad. Va a llegar. Va a
Listening to the game on their AM as well, then listening the FM version of that, because you know Graham hit it, obviously.
Right. I just like that he like. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what he's saying, but it sounds like he broke into song.
He knows it's a 63-yarder, and that's a long way to win a game.
Yeah, you're right, man. It got me fired up, and I have no idea.
Just
what
ask
saying.
Mason Crosby.
Yeah, right. That's what I'm saying. Like that call is so exciting. So then. I was trying to explain to Mike earlier that there. You guys know Gus Johnson, right?
Yes.
Yes. From the Cowboys and now an announcer.
Gus Johnson played in the NFL?
I think so.
Yeah.
Mind blown. All right. I love Gus Johnson as an announcer. I thought he was just an announcer. I never realized he was an NFL football player, too. So Gus Johnson is very polarizing because he gets very excited. Okay.
Sure.
So a few years ago, he did some soccer for Fox, and people got pissed because they're like, he doesn't know what he's talking about. I get excited. I love Gus Johnson. Now he's calling the end of the Texas-Oklahoma game, the Red River Shootout, Red River rivalry now in 2018.
Of course.
Right?
Gus Johnson did not play in the NFL.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Mind not blown.
He went to the University of Detroit Jesuit High School and Academy. Graduated from Howard.
Oh, with a I like him even more.
With a degree in political science.
All right, so Gus Johnson
he played baseball.
Famous for getting very fired up. Texas, keep in mind, should have never beat Oklahoma. They're going to nail a kick to win this thing, and the kicker has a great last name for Gus.
Excellent! He hit it! Kicker! The kicker! 48-45, Texas!
What do you call him?
His last name is Dicker.
The guy's last name is Dicker.
Dicker the Kicker.
So he just
Dicker.
Goes, Dicker! The Kicker! I was there earlier in that game at one point, Texas scored a touchdown, and he goes, touchdown, Texas! And they are eating barbecue in Austin!
Sounds like the guy used to call the Pens matches.
I know.
Who's eating fried chicken today?
I was like, what are you talking about?
When I heard that Spanish call, I was trying to think of like who, you know, because.
Oh, Jesus.
Dang.
You splattered.
Like a zipper in my anus.
Because.
Oh, really?
Ooh, right. Jailbreak.
Yeah, that's what they were singing about.
It's going to be a jailbreak.
I'd rather hear a cowboy song.
Who's the guy that does all the American announce that everybody hates? Joe Buck.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because he's just kind of like, hey, I'm Joe Buck.
Home run, Yankees win the World
Series. Yeah, so that's what I like about Gus Johnson. He gets fired up. Plus, I think sometimes, I don't know if he do you think out Dicker the Kicker before the game? Or is that just a spur of the moment, like...
It sounded spur of the moment because of his pause.
Do you notice when he farts that she uses hand sanitizer?
And then waves
like, that's going to help? Like her hands, like she caught the fart in her hands.
Well, it does smell very alcoholic.
Robin looks like the crazy woman who's swatting at bugs that aren't there.
Did you walk through a spider net?
Right.
Spider webs.
She has all this hand sanitizer and waves them, but
oh no!
You look like you're at a weird Southern Baptist retreat. You know what I mean? When they're getting deep into stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's. You need to videotape it. So you can see yourself,
he
Robin.
He will heal you. You will be healed.
Right.
Cleanse this room.
We're about to put the snake on her neck.
I mean, evil spirits come out.
Yeah, she's deep in it.
The spirits.
Oh, hell, I grew up in the Pentecostal church.
Hey.
The spirits. Which I'm still not
sure. Pentecostal.
Does anyone know what a spirit is?
All right. People get sick. They like to go to WebMD and commit some
self-diagnose, yeah.
All right. Well, now there might be a TV show about that.
No.
TNT is working on a new reality show where the studio audience will help diagnose people's illnesses.
Until they get sued for killing seven people.
On live TV.
Look.
No matter what.
The show's called MD Live. It'll have a panel of legit medical professionals, right, to actually diagnose the patients. But they're also going to ask the audience for feedback, solutions, and support.
Okay, look, Sour Brains Oxley, when they passed that, didn't change the way the game is played. When you watch television, they will show you an ad.
Right.
And it says, ask your doctor, do you...
Right, that's their one out.
You jackass at home, you who has no idea what the frick you're talking about in the world of med... You weren't even close to med school.
Right.
I wasn't even... I walked by a med school accidentally one time in a city. That's the closest I've been to it. Like, you should ask that guy who spent 10 years of his life specializing in one thing about something that you know absolutely effing nothing about.
Right.
So we're kind of already trained to have that mentality to be like, well, I'm no doctor, but Christ.
But I did have trouble sleeping
so
last
like,
night.
This makes perfect sense. You know what I mean? Of course
the difference is on a live audit, you might, because they have actual practitioners there, right?
Yeah.
So they might say,
well, I'm
look,
sure
man,
you're going to get a good diagnosis eventually.
But that's the problem, right? Because I don't know what I have. I'm on live TV. The practitioner, the doctor says, hey, man, guess what? The audience was wrong. You're like, oh, thank God.
What if the audience is right?
And you
the
have doctor, gonorrhea.
And the doctor's wrong for a change.
But I mean, that's man, you have an STD. Like, that's not the one
Zap,
that I want on
cancer's
TV.
Cancer's back.
Right.
Thanks, doc.
And is it going to be like the Price is Right? Are people going to yell out stuff?
I would think so. Wouldn't you?
I mean, I'd
be like, leukemia. He said his feet are numb. Cancer. I mean, just going to say anything.
All right, this is going to be a mess.
Yeah. But they're talking about actual cases here, legit issues. TNT said, quote, they'll have top bio. Yeah.
Those guys. Biomedical.
Bioethicists.
Yes.
All right. To ensure the medical team is able to provide the best patient forward support.
If they really cared, they'd say, hey, why don't you do this at the doctor?
They really cared, they'd give you health insurance and care.
I just think I don't know. That one seems crazy. I mean, but look, I've said this before. The live PD to one is kind of crazy too. You never seen that?
No.
It's called Live PD, where it's like Scott Hansen standing in her room, and it's like, all right, let's go down to Memphis. Looks like they're pulling somebody over.
Yeah, but at least on that show, like, if you're getting busted by the cops, you didn't, like, volunteer to be on the show, your day is just a little worse. On this show, look, Ted, you went to the doctor a couple years ago, man, I got this weird bump, it's near my junk, and like, dude, it's an ingrown hair, right? But
right.
That's good news, but imagine being on that show and like not an ingrown hair this
herpes.
Time.
Ted's got a herpes,
right? Because the audience is going, "You have the herp," right? And then he's got the herp,
and then he goes,
"You do not have herpes."
He's
not have herpes.
Yeah,
he's a herpetrator.
Exactly.
You know,
all I do is win.
No matter what. Not if I know it's a hair bump.
All right. So we're bringing out Dr. Pimple Popper to take that thing off your shaft.
He got the herp. Gotta get the herb. Ow.
Today's show brought to you by Valtrax.
Right.
All right. A lot of famous people, they get into certain types of restaurants and bars, what have you. One of those new people is Shaq. Now, Shaq owns multiple businesses. Shaq, actually, I'm pretty sure, has been very good with his money.
He should have Radio Shaq.
Yeah.
I'll release Shaq Fu.
So basically, he's got a new Shaq chicken.
Right,
and he's going to have a show. I believe his show's going to be on Facebook.
Should be called the Chicken Shack, right?
I think it's just the Big Chicken Shack.
Okay, well, that makes sense.
He was on with Fallon, and he talked about it. This is hands-on.
Big Chicken Shack, this is, you open up a chicken restaurant, or you're opening up one in Vegas.
I'm opening up a chicken restaurant in Vegas.
Why?
I already have a couple of restaurants in Vegas that are doing successful, but this one is different because I'm the CEO, I'm in charge, I'm at the front. All my other restaurants I delegate to, you know, because, you know, one of my mottos is hiring people that are very smart than me, so I let them do the work. But this one, Big Chicken, this is my baby. I'm doing all the work. I'm with construction, hiring, menu, and...
Really?
Yes.
That's what the show's about, but how, I mean, so your management skill, would you say your management style?
My management style is similar to yours. I try to make people at ease. You know, I don't act like I know everything, because from playing basketball, I realize that you can't win championships by yourself. You have to utilize your teammates. So I just try to make everybody at ease. And, you know, I don't have a problem listening.
Yeah, him and Kobe were always tight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he makes a good point. He does make a good point. You would never know that Shaq owns two restaurants in Las Vegas because he's not involved in it. He lets the guys that are the... he's an investor.
I just want to point out one thing.
I know. I'm just saying it's kind of funny listening to Shaquille. I mean, him and Kobe were winning championships.
Right. And hated each other.
Hated each other. Right. Like, to the point where he was, like, rapping stuff on Kobe, like, calling him out.
Do you think he said something nice to him for a change there? Wouldn't you say? Like, you can't win a championship without good players.
But I think that's his point. Like, man, learn to live with it. learn to live with it if you're going to achieve what it is you want to do, right? I mean, that's what
is
you
that
do.
A shot at Kobe?
And no, I think it's a guy that is way past his career. Just be like, yeah, I learned that. Like, it's just stuff people say.
Right.
I will say this, though.
I don't think him and Kobe still dislike each other that much. But honestly, like,
they don't like
each
other.
They were the two biggest basketball stars in the world on the same team. So every springtime, they would kind of put aside their differences to go for a championship. Sure. And then by the time you got to that summer, it was like, and don't forget, I'm Shaq. He's like, don't forget, I'm Kobe.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Also, by the way, just for the pure size of the man, I trust his chicken. That's absolutely a large man.
Dude, if you're in, if you're in Vegas and you're drunk and you walk by Shaq's Chicken Shack at 1 o'clock in the morning, and you can look in the window,
Big Chicken Shack,
and see the fried chicken.
Like, I don't try to make anybody think that I know about. Like with a voice like that, no one does. I mean, look, I don't think he's stupid. I don't at all. But, like, dude, when you sound like that, you don't know. I don't want anybody to think that I know everything going on. They don't. They don't. You can't sound like that. You go, yo, man, what do you think about relativity? You know what I mean? Like, look, he might know a lot.
Well,
this is the way you sound. Think about it. You trust the voice of Stephen Hawking more than Jack Swope to give him information.
Chicken in motion stays in motion.
He doesn't subscribe.
Thank you, Tim. We appreciate it. Mike's got your headlines coming up here in just a few minutes. You are listening to the Men's Room Radio Network.
The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill. Now, let's see what's happening in the real world.
All right, here we go. Florida man witnesses fourth strongest hurricane and landfall is hitting his home state. Meanwhile, if you live in the city and you go trick-or-treating at age 13, your chance of getting arrested is actually kind of great. Both women and emotional support squirrel are kicked off a plane. The story of a man getting his entire penis ripped off by a dog is truly insane. And in Nashville, a haunted house with real blood. It is time for your headlines.
Now, it's time to hit the head. Lines. Here's Mike Hawk.
Our top story in Orlando. Airport passengers cheered as a woman was removed from her flight in a wheelchair while flipping off the crowd. Why the poppin' circumstance? The woman had previously warned the airline that she had an emotional support animal with her, but neglected to mention that it was a squirrel.
Nobody gave you a goddamn emotional support squirrel.
No. No, they did not.
What is wrong with you that that's the animal they pick?
How in the world did you grab the squirrel in the first place?
Offered a Cheeto, bro. That's pretty easy.
And, like, does it just crawl all over and you know, make her feel happy, or does it kind of stay in a cage most of the time?
I mean, are support animal, are these things given to you by a doctor? I'm just wondering because, so, like, you get the dog, you get the...
That's a good question.
No, you get the dog.
They are things that bring you emotional comfort in this instance, and I'm not sure that a squirrel qualifies.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
it's
just
because it's not
person?
A traditional pet. And
because
I'm not saying
typically,
that
it's the companionship, as I understand, a lot of times that's what helps. So with the dog, you get it.
Well, and a lot of these animals are trained. It said that they are actually trained to see if your emotional state is
absolutely
in a dangerous situation.
So
and then they'll work
peacocks
to fix it. Right.
Not trained. And now we have the squirrel. Come on, man.
When told that she couldn't have the animal on board and would need to deplane, she refused and officers got involved, causing a 2-hour delay.
You must deplane.
I mean, right, why? Just
right,
for her the squirrel. Plane.
Right. You know it's not going to be allowed. They told you it's not going to be allowed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. In other news, let's go to Scotland, where a man caused a much more amusing delay. The man was caught sitting in a red leather armchair in the middle of a busy intersection. He's a 54-year-old man, complete with a suit and fedora, and even appeared to doze off for a few minutes despite the honks and swerves of traffic around him.
That's amazing that he could take a nap there.
I don't know.
All things
really
considered.
Did.
Well, he at least tried.
He was there for like 10 minutes, so okay. I don't know that he actually took a nap, but that would be funny if he actually did. He wasn't there long before he left the scene with the chair pulled it to the side of the road.
Okay.
That's funny. I like it.
I like his style.
A photo online is proving to be slightly polarizing. I want to get you guys' take on this one. The photo shows a BMW in the UK that a man used two parking spots to protect. We've seen people do it before.
Sure.
Usually they're at the other end of a grocery store doing it, but sometimes they kind of get up right there to the front. This was in a parking structure, and he took up two spots. Where was I at here? But if you look in the window, you can see that he paid for two parking spots. He actually paid the hourly rate for two parking spots. There have been multiple responses online, mostly agreeing that the man's kind of a jerk, but some giving him more of a pass for paying for two spots.
I'll give you more of a pass for paying for the two spots without question. I'm glad you did your due diligence, but in the end, if I want to park my car, I want the space.
Exactly.
I mean, that's all it is.
I mean, that's the bigger issue.
It's like, I'm glad you did that.
It's like the guy who has his backpack on your bus seat. You're like, hey, man, it's standing room, man. Can you just... Everyone's got your stuff on.
But even if he paid for that.
What kind of car was it?
BMW.
Let's say what, series?
Doesn't really say the series of it.
All right.
I have seven series
is big. Right? Is it the big one? Seven series?
Nah, yeah. If you get even numbers, brother, it's a different level.
I mean, seven series is like the super expensive. The, right, six, the six series.
Love six.
It's insane.
Right. A lot of people are saying it's nothing special, that it's just a BMW.
What is so the six? The two doors?
It looks like the Batmobile. You just when you see one, you'll be like, oh, that's the six series.
All right, it has happened again, gentlemen. It is time for another edition of Bad Parenting. Today we go to Pennsylvania
with the okie doke.
Fart again?
I did.
Oh, Robin,
damn,
dude,
blowing it away.
Robin just gave me the eye. Look, I didn't say anything.
Today we go to Pennsylvania where a woman was arrested after her 11-year-old son was found walking down the street unsupervised, staggering drunk on whiskey.
Damn it.
How old? 11.
When I wonder he got drunk.
When police arrived at the house after a call was made, they found that the boy had drank nine mini Fireball.
Oh my God.
Bottles. His blood alcohol level was at 0.41.
Mike, can you do me a favor?
Yes.
Not that I want to say too much about a theory that we've randomly approached on this show many times, but could you tell me the name of that mother of the year? I know you're not working on most.
No, I am working on this one. Ah! Her name was Tina.
Yep, of course.
Okay. I didn't know if you noticed that part of the story. I sure
did. I didn't take notice.
I did not know that.
Oh, that was the first thing I looked at.
You are the better journalist, Miles. Boy. It was also noted that the woman's 13-year-old daughter had a pack of cigarettes in her bra.
That is true.
Oh, in her bra?
In her bra.
Just like mom.
What is
going on?
My
God.
Hold on. The kid is 4.
Which kid?
You said the 4-year-old, you said
no,
that?
13-year-old.
Oh, 13-year-old. Okay, all right.
She's got a pack of smokes in her bra.
Yeah, and the 11-year-old wears a bra.
The 11-year-old smashed.
It just sounded to me like kids trying to emulate their mother.
That's
like,
exactly what it is.
But what kind of 4-year-old has a bra on?
The kind that's trying to emulate their mother. Like, I don't remember which one did what, but I thought all these kids want to be like their mom.
She was a pro. All right, are you ready, Miles?
Sure.
A woman in Michigan told herself that if she won $50 on an instant scratch-off ticket, that she would put that money towards the state super raffle lottery, which she did. And she's now loving that decision as it made her $100,000.
Nice. What a great story. Some people get to go to Portugal. Some people want $100,000.
Suck it. You could go to Portugal if you had $100,000.
Oh, man.
The money's going to go toward debts and home improvement projects.
And a trip to Portugal.
I feel like we were talking about this recently. A haunted house in Madison got a lot more real after an actor didn't quite check his equipment. The actor approached a couple and asked the woman if the man was, quote, effing around with her. After she jokingly said yes, the actor handed the woman a knife and said to stab him. Which, you know, it's cutesy. It's fun. All right. She did because the knife...
You say it's Madison?
Madison.
Got it. Happened in Nashville.
The knife was completely real. He's okay. That's it for headlines. Mike Hawkins out.
Thank you, Mike. We appreciate it. We'll see you next time for Big Dummy, the head chef in the house. Ted's meat and potatoes, no ash, Sherlock, and we'll drink and toast with a shot of the day.
Yes, indeed. It's all true. But in the meantime, we be all about this badge. So until next time, please do what you do best. And for Aletha's sake, stay beautiful.
The men's room has been taped before a live studio audience. Wardrobe and makeup provided by Mantastic Limited. This has been a presentation of the Men's Room Radio Network.
Aw, oh, man!
A Double Flush production.
Sparkly.
I'm bubbly.
And together,
we're Mineraqua.
The fresh, sparkling water for those who are bubbling over with life.
And crave new experiences.
Are you thirsty for adventure, more laughs, and more excitement?
With Mineraqua in hand, it's easy to live life with sparkle.
Just look for the glass bottles with tiny bubbles wrapped in blue.
And you'll taste and feel the difference of Mineraqua sparkling water.
Mineraqua, get your fizz.